Hi everyone, and welcome to our channel. This is lesson 4 in our series 3D Modeling for Newbies. We're going to continue to look at our two-rail sweep option. We're going to take an existing model from our 3D component library and make some adjustments to it. We're also going to look at how to make a flag. A flag with waves. It's a rather popular item, and I'll show you a few little tricks that could be done. I'll show you how the curls could be made. These are especially important if you're creating coats of arms. And one of my favorites is the Viking ship. How to create the hull of the boat using the two-rail sweep. So let's get started. I open a new session of Aspire, and I just bring in the clip art that's found within the clip art library. It's nice, but I'd like to change the stem of it to make it a little bit different. I draw some vectors that I want to then cut apart the model. I want to cut apart the stem from the flower itself. Click on the component, click on the vector, and cut. Now I have two different components. I then choose the model cross-section option. Within the measure tool, you click on the model cross-section and drag your cursor across the area of the component that you would like to create the vector. But take a look and make sure you have the least amount of nodes that you could. This will ensure that your end product is of high quality. Within the software, there's a list of gadgets that are available to use. These are little shortcuts that help you in your designing. There's one called the Spiral. If you don't have it, you can simply download it from the Vectric website. I have the link in the description below if you need it. I choose my Spiral gadget, choose the option of the design of the spiral that I want, and click OK. I position that spiral where I want it, and I make a copy of it. I now position that second spiral to look like the stem that I'm interested in. I select those new spiral vectors as my rails and the cross section and hit apply. Now I have the same profile shape of the tail, but in a slightly different look. This is how easy adjusting 3D models within the software can be. The next item, the flag. It seems to be a rather popular item for people to make. I'll show you a few examples of how it can be done, a few examples of the profiles that will create different folds and waves. But I'm also going to show you a little trick that we haven't addressed before. So let's get started. A new session of Aspire. I create the vectors that I want. One item to consider is, if you're going to be creating a flag, make sure that the dimensions of the flag are accurate. And also, the wavy profile that you're going to use for your profile and two-rail sweep, make sure that no part of it goes below the start or end nodes of your vector. If it does, you're going to wind up having holes in your flag. So, just like before, we have our two rails. They extend beyond the perimeter of the flag size that we want. We have a left rail and a right rail going in the same direction. We click on the profile that we want and click apply. The end result, the component is larger than our flag, but that's okay. We simply choose the vector that we created of the shape of the flag, hold the shift key down and click the component, and then delete or keep what we want. Just a note, I've created a component showing the stars and stripes simply for visuals. I would expect you would use other toolpathing options to create those. V-carving for the stars and a pocket for the stripes, then creating a component and cutting it all out in that sense. Let's try another way. The vectors are in a different position, a different slant, and a different profile look. Again, keep what I want of that newly created component of the flag. Then we'll show the stars and stripes. Again, simply for the visuals, so you can get a feeling of what your end product is going to look like. This profile is a little smoother, a little more gentle of a wave. Let's try it one more time. Hopefully you're getting to see how easy it is to make a wavy flag using the two-rail sweep option. Okay, last time. Let's see what we can do. We have our two rails. Click on the icon for the two-rail sweep. Those are the rails we'll use. We're going to click on our profile. And the component is created. Now, to be honest, this is okay, but it's not exactly what I wanted. The waves, in my opinion, are too consistent. I want the top of the flag to be a little softer in the waves and a little bit more pronounced at the bottom. So here's an option that you can use that we had not addressed before. I'm going to delete this original component, and I'm going to create a new vector. We have our first one at the very bottom of our flag, but the new one, a simple arch, is going to be located at the top. So, in this case, we choose our rails, as we've done before. But now, I'm going to choose my first vector of the arch and apply it to the top of the two-rail sweep. And then I'm going to click on my second profile and attach it to the bottom, or the end of the rails. And what's going to happen is that profile shape of the first arch will transition from its shape into the waves, thereby creating a flag that is slightly different than previous, and gives you a very subtle change from one to another. Hopefully you can see the two-rail sweep option offers endless possibilities. Take some time and play with it. I think you'll enjoy it. Another item that's very, very popular are coats of arms and architectural details. Here's an example of how to create some of those parts. We have two different profiles, which are mirror image of one another, and our rails. So of course, as usual, we select our rails, we select the first shape that's on the left, we apply it to the start of the rails, and the high side of that profile is going to run along our first vector. I have the option of scale cross-section with width chosen within the software, and that causes the shape to be a little bit distorted, where the distance between each rail is further apart, the height of the Z of that shape will be taller. And I can also uncheck that scale width, so it winds up having an even Z height. As an example now, I want to delete the cross-sections. We're going to use our first profile at the beginning of the rails and our second profile shape at the ends. Now, the high side of the profile will start on the left and transition to end up being on the right. Adding extra profiles to our shape, again, helps to control any distortion that we may see. I choose more vectors to create another component shape, simple curves to create new components, the rails are running in the same direction, my profile. In this case, it works okay, but I want this shape to be a little bit more bulbous. So I check the scale option. And where the rails are further apart, the component is higher in the Z. And where they're closer together, they're lower in the Z. This is what I'd like to see. I've created an extra set of vectors as my cutout to delete parts of this component. Creating models out of component shapes is a piece-by-piece operation. Each one needs to be made separately. I have my new component of the curl top, and I add it to the previous one that we created. With a little bit of practice, you get to be rather quick at making these items. It's just a few decisions, a few vectors, and a few profiles. We've created this component using a couple profiles. Let's try this one more time, using multiple profile shapes. This is a Viking boat I've been working on. If you really look closely at it, I think you'd be able to make it also. The flag is simple vectors with a wave to it, a two-rail sweep. The ropes and the mast are simple components from closed vectors that we learned how to make basically in lesson one, but the hull of the boat may present itself as a challenge. I've drawn several different profiles of what I think the hull of the boat should look like. Thinner at the beginning and the end of the boat, and thicker in the center. And the process of using the two-rail sweep for this operation is the same. I select the first vector, hold the shift key down and select the second, and then I go to place the profiles. The smaller, thinner profile at the very beginning. And I place the second shape where I think it would be appropriate. Our third shape, it gets thicker and thicker. The middle of the boat is the thickest, in my opinion. That's where the next and largest profile would be placed. And then it morphs back to a smaller shape as it gets to the tail of the boat. I can adjust the starting and end points of that profile as need be, so they're directly across from one another. And when I have them positioned, I click Apply. Of course, I name this component to help me remember what part of the boat it is. And our end result. Multiple profiles, but simply a two-rail sweep. And this is the end result. As we've said, the hull was the most challenging. Everything else is rather simple. All you really need to do is think through it step by step, item by item, and take your time. Easy enough? Certainly. Challenging? Without a doubt. Because the possibilities wind up being endless. Hopefully you got to see a little bit more of the possibilities using the two-rail sweep. It's a powerful tool within the software that I use on a regular basis. Our next lesson, number 5, we're going to look at the extrude and weave option, another powerful tool that can help you design interesting items. If you've liked what you've seen and you want to learn more, subscribe to our channel. Make sure you hit the little bell so that you can be notified of our next video. And of course, if you have any questions, send me an email, mm@mezalick.com. Thanks for watching. See you next time, and enjoy.